coming. I really appreciate it. Thank you to FM and Bonita for hosting us. So exciting to go to a different location. And do you guys have anything you want to say?
Yeah, well, thank you guys for considering us, at least. It's a new way of doing business now, right now, with everything going on, this COVID thing, the economy down and everything.
Anybody in the community that has ideas, give them to Jody or I, and we'll compile a deal and see if we can get the young entrepreneurs going. And no matter how big or how small, we've got to come up with plans, and the more people we have helping, the better.
That's right. I'm good with that. Definitely. Anybody else? Miss anything? Yes?
I feel like I ought to tell you what's going on at City Hall, but quite frankly, all I know is what I read in the newspaper. But certainly, we need to support our elected officials and help them work through this difficult situation. Because we've incurred a lot of debt, we've got some budgeting issues, but I say we because I feel like I'm part of the community. We all are. We don't want to send anybody home, we want to keep everybody working. That's it.
And support our businesses, yep. Definitely. Okay, well, that was fast, so thank you guys for coming, I really appreciate it. And next month we'll be at McDermott. Oh.
I was going to ask FM some questions.
Oh, yeah. Go right ahead.
Tell us about the difference between your buildings and those buildings. I mean, you do it a little different. You make everything right here.
Predominantly, yes. Yeah. We have a fabrication shop here. We have material suppliers around the country that we bring in material from, but in bulk material. And we're wanting to grow that more even yet. We'll get into more of the overhead doors. You know, I had a guy explain to me something the other day that really changed my attitude. But one of the things always considered a deterrent to Northwest Oklahoma is the limited access. We had the materials and supplies, and most of the things on our shelf are things that we're not competing with other people about. It's things that we need to support our men, but you can't buy it out. Or even, for that matter, even in some cases, not even Oklahoma City. But what the internet has done for us, we complain a lot about how it's challenged all the local businesses, and, you know, it's changed the dynamics of a big change like Sears. But what it's also done in our favor has given us access to everything. And so no longer are we really out there with things unavailable. We have as much availability as anybody. So, you know, our excuse of being out here in remote areas kind of fall apart. And yes, there's some down things, but there's some up things. And so, you know, sometimes, and I'm as bad as anybody, I tend to be a pessimistic, I have a pessimistic attitude. And but when we really look at what's going for us, there's nothing holding us back. And you know, so I'm still kind of excited. I think that the initial problems are worldwide, but as far as this business and what we produce and the way we produce it, I'm still excited about it. And
I appreciate what you said about the internet. I think there's so many opportunities for anybody anywhere now with the internet. You could start an Amazon in Alva, Oklahoma if you had the money to get started. You're not limited to your, like you said, where you live anymore. And I think that's a great thing that we could actually use.
But our attitude is to focus on that and being the devil, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
Or our big enemy. And it has been a change for us, but quite frankly, they haven't paid attention to the Greeks.
Yeah.
They've got complacent about the way they do it. And so I think our community needs to, above all, guard against complacency and just look to the horizon all the time, try to figure out what the trends are. Art has probably been one of the most ingenious men in Alva for that. You know, that little lot up there, I go by it with amazement every time. Because for years and years, I was just there, and people would ask to put stuff there, but Art turned it into a village. But, you know, just realizing what's around us is what's important. We get in such an attitude of demise that we can't see the opportunity.
Yeah.
So I think for Alva, the last thing we want to do is get down about things and try to look at the upside. And there is opportunity here. I don't know how we sell it to other people right now, the way things are. But we have a lot of outsiders moving into the community again, and there's opportunity there. That's where we're building our biggest, best structure for these guys from other parts of the country that are buying land out here and hunting on and do little farming operations. And, you know, they look at our economy like it's an absolute value. You know? And I'm not sure I like that, but I appreciate it. But Neil has helped us with the biggest hurdle, little difficult to not get down when you see businesses closing. And, one of the things I probably ought to have not mentioned, but I hate to see the Taco Mile building end up being anything other than a restaurant. I thought it was a perfect deal. Had our, I don't know where our economic development stands right now. It would have been nice if we could have bought that building and give opportunity to someone to open a new restaurant. We got a lot of things going in Alva's and we like that need to be sustainable, need other businesses to support, like the arena and things like that. And I keep looking at things like if I were a college student coming to Alva, the Northwestern, what would be my draw? Bonnie and I eat out a lot because of our lifestyle, but you get really tired of the same old place. But anyhow, that's maybe one of the hurdles that we ought to look at is how do we draw, get some of the support businesses and maybe go with the bigger offer. Because sometimes we look at the big things and leave out the little things. And you know, that new arena is going to be a major thing. And offer a lot if we can support it. And, you know, but it's, I'm sure that eventually everything will work out fine.
The draw for Northwestern is the scholarships that gets them here. And the other is just gravy.
Yeah.
Or keeps them here. Because I talked to, it's been a long time ago, but I went to things in, or tried to see, I don't know who it was. Talking to someone from out of town, and they said, well, our kid came to Northwestern because we told them they needed to come the first year because of the scholarships. And they fell in love with Alva, and they wanted to come back.
The affordability, I think in today's world, with the affordability of Northwestern, it's a big thing.
Well, that scholarship program is absolutely critical to our recruitment. I mean, it's a very unique program. My knowledge, no other schools around have anything anywhere near that. And it's, you talk to our recruitment staff, it is oftentimes the difference that will attract that student from a competitor who's coming here. And you're right, most students fall in love with our
team. And I've recruited in airports when we've traveled. And some of them come. I think we were on one of our trips.
Pardon?
I said we were on one of the trips with you guys in an airport or on a bus or something, and was telling them about Northwestern and the lease network. And they are amazed at the high rate of getting into the med schools and the nursing programs. And,
sometimes we overlook the real highlights of where we live because we're so accustomed to it. You know, I have people come into our area and just gasp at the beauty of our surroundings. I look around like, what do you see? But, you know, I like to go to Colorado Mountains. That's my idea of beautiful scenery. But, you know, then you sit and think, well, I guess people from Colorado come down there and look at our backpack. But sometimes we just don't see all the opportunity around us.
You just need to build more trees around your house.
Yeah. There's certainly a lot of things we can push better than we've done it. And when we get out traveling, we talk avidly about where we live, and that's one of those things. There's a new couple in our church that moved here from Montana, and they seem to just love us in the city. But you know, one of the things I've always had going to for it was a great retirement town. And I hope we can hold that. I think the hospital is a critical element to that. And health care system in general. And that's getting more and more difficult to prop up, it seems like, in competition in the world. So there's certain key elements that we really need to guard against, I think. And Botech, the college, obviously, and hospital, and all of those services have just got to be there. And housing is less of a problem than it was, but I think it's still a problem. We've got two classes of houses that are both at the far end of the spectrum. seem like Wes and Mills back in Marshall make me work. But I've got a guy at Enid that keeps calling me. I've got to go meet him. But he didn't want to start a new project there north of Enid somewhere. They want to build 18 new metal frame homes. And wants us to do the frames, and he wants to finish out the inside. And he's looking to get a home out for about $95 a square foot, which is another little solution. But we got to, that's probably a lesser problem now than the job prices. With the decline in the energy sector, that's really hurt our community. We've got a lot of unemployment again, a lot of people in. They're still not really knowing what their future looks like. But, tough challenge for the chamber, for Neil, and the ones trying to hold things together. I'm with the banking industry, not much better.
Right.
You want to probably help all you can and be cautious. We were impressed. Jody asked us to do this, kind of showed a sign of her eagerness to do her duty, and it really drove that facet of her community. And I'm looking forward to seeing her in action.
Thank you. Anybody else have anything? Todd, do you have anything?
No, just let me.
When I came in on Eagle Sickle, I didn't really know what we were expecting to serve. And I said, well, you can't go wrong with donuts. And in the newspaper today, it said a quote from someone who said they got choked on a carrot. And he said, that would never happen to me with a donut.
Thank you.
We were at a trade show here a while back, and there was a group of PETA people, and they were sitting right next to a cattle loader booth.
Okay, well, thank you guys so much.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, I appreciate it.